Hello, my name is Thomas Eisenberger. I will present you the work Haptic Rendering of Soft Tissue for Training Surgical Procedures at the Larynx. The tracheotomy is an open surgical procedure and is used by acute swelling of the respiratory tract or tumors of the upper respiratory tract. The physician wants to access the trachea. First step is to cut between the second and third or between the third and fourth tracheal cartilage. After that, the physician opens the cut and stitches the skin to the trachea. The last one is to insert a cannula. We want to simulate the first step, so the cut through the skin of 3 to 4 centimeters. Typically, surgical training is based on the C1, do1, teach1 concept. This means the student C1 procedure. After that, the student do1, and lastly, when the student is an expert, teach one. Another way is to use 3D printed models. The 3D printed models are expensive and can only be used once. An alternative is to use animal phantoms, but these are hard to obtain. The solution is virtual surgical training. So it's available 24/7, and you can use patient-specific data. Here you see a training of a knee procedure, and here of an endoscopic procedure. We have our heart tissue simulator. It's based on the haptic arm from Hubzion, the Virtuose 6D desktop, and the 3D monitor of C-front is an arthroscopic 3D monitor, and medical scenario, in our case, the segmentation of the inner and middle ear. Here you see our simulator with the petrosal bone, the middle, and here you see the milling procedure. This one is the arthroscopic monitor, and this one is a touch monitor with the CD data and the control of the different blades and different diameters of the mill. Here you can see the rotation and the moving of the bone. We have CT data of the head and neck, and this data is segmented with the 3D slicer. Here you can see in brown the skin, in yellow the fat, in green the thyroid gland, in blue the trachea, and in gray is over here and here the tracheal cartilages. We use a scalpel by Swan Morton as a model for the physical model. And we generated a 3D model in Blender of this one. The 3D model has the same geometry as the physical model. Position-based dynamics is a method to simulate soft tissue, fluids, and gases. Here, you see one particle, And the whole mesh is converted into particles. We use the NVIDIA Flex library for the position-based dynamics. So NVIDIA Flex is CUDA accelerated. This means that the simulation runs on the graphics card and has a great performance. You can model soft and hard tissue, and the constraints are solved in parallel. This is the communication between the hard tissue and our new NVIDIA Flex implementation. The orange one is the Chai4T library. We use this library for the hard tissue simulator. In this library, we generate the objects like the bone and the mill and the haptics. So if an object moves, it goes to the haptics and we get a force to the haptic arm. The haptic arm delivers the position to the library and updates the objects. The objects are rendered by OpenGL, and now we have integrated the NVIDIA Flex library here. So this means if the haptic arm moves, the position goes to the Chai3D library and then to the NVIDIA Flex library. Here, the NVIDIA Flex library takes the position of the objects and the position of the haptic arm, calculates the haptic feedback, sends the force value back to the Chai3D, and this one sends the force to the haptic arm. NVIDIA Flex is for the soft mesh, for the skin and fat and etc. And Chai4T for the hard tissue, like bones. We use a 1D representation of the scalpel to simplify the computation according to the Bernd et al. Here you see the scalpel in 1D. This one are the particles of the skin or fat, so of the soft tissue. And for the force calculation, we use a finger proxy algorithm. And this algorithm, we have the variable PI. PI is the position of the particle, and PI projected is the position of the particle projected to the scalpel. We sum up this term over all particles which are colliding with the scalpel and get our force. The simulation of NVIDIA Flex is lower than 1000 Hz, and we need a frequency over 1000 Hz for the haptic feedback, so we have to extrapolate the force, and we use an approach by Bikin, Bono and Lombardo. Here you can see some parameters of the soft tissue from NVIDIA Flex. We have here the spacing of the particles. We use lower than 5 millimeters to gain a realistic feeling. Then we have the number of particles. This range is multiplied by 50,000 by NVIDIA Flex. So this means if we have here 10, then we have 500,000 particles. N sample stands for the number of samples in the mesh, not on the surface, but in the mesh. D is for the distance between the clusters, and it's between 1.5 and 6 millimeters. The R cluster is the radius of the cluster. So this one is the distance between the clusters, and here the radius. If we are manipulating the radius, we change the overlap of the clusters. The S cluster is the stiffness of the cluster between 0 and 1. 0 means no stiffness, 1 means hard tissue. And S global is the global stiffness. If we are using 1 over 0, we can use the S cluster. Otherwise, it would not be possible. Results, we have a concept of the real-time interaction between position-based dynamics and the haptic arm. We tested all interfaces and the synchronization between the haptic arm and the NVIDIA flags are working. The forces are calculated by NVIDIA flags and sent to the haptic arm. Here you can see the rendered object with the skin, fat, and the bones, and the scalpel in the foreground. We have developed a soft tissue model with haptic feedback. The model is integrated into our hard tissue simulator, and one drawback, many parameter configurations you've seen before are not suitable, so the particles move away after some time. And it's hard to set individual material properties for different, for the skin and fat and so on. This is because NVIDIA flags just have one parameter for the iteration, and the stiffness depends on the number of iterations. We want to test more parameter sets and extend the simulator by fluids, gases, and more instruments like scissors. Thank you for your attention.